رب ومن يزغ منهم عن أمرنا نذقه من عذاب السعير يعملون له ما يشاء من محاريب وتماثيل وجفان كالجواب وقدور الراسيات يعملوا آل داود شكرا وقليل من عبادي الشكور.
ولسليمان الريح and we made the wind subservient for سليمان. غدوها شهر ورواحها شهر. He comfortably covered the distance which would be covered in a month on a camel back or horseback with a swift conveyance in one morning. ورواحها شهر and in the afternoon. To which land? إلى الأرض التي باركنا فيها. The land that we had blessed. And that was Sham. The point is, what's the point, brother? He parted with something for the pleasure of Allah. He came home with the winds. He came home with the winds. As the immediate benefit, Allah alone knows what Allah will give him in Akhirah. The reward of goodness is in Akhirah. This is just the things of this world. ولما ترك المهاجرون ديارهم لله وأوطانهم التي هي أحب شيء إليهم عاذهم الله أن فتح عليهم الدنيا وملكهم شرق الأرض وغربها. When the Muhajirin had forsaken their native land Mecca on the command of Allah because of the hostility of the infidels and they were compelled to journey beyond and they had to leave their native land and they came to Medina and it's not easy to acclimatize, it's not easy to adapt. And remember today with all luxuries, with all ease, you can Google it, you can go online, you can do everything, you can transfer your funds, you can establish yourself there, you can have an economic muscle here, you can have a base there, you can have a home there, so many things, yet you yearn back for home. This was leaving Mecca knowing not what the future was ahead. They made this migration and they were prepared to forsake their native land. أعاذهم الله أن فتح عليهم الدنيا وملكهم شرق الأرض وغربها. In lieu of them leaving their native land, Allah opened up the east and the west of the entire world to their feet. They became the rulers of the continents. And where they took the deen of Allah. وكذلك السارق لو ترك سرقة المال لآتاه الله مثله حلالا. Likewise a thief, if he stops his theft, Allah will give him that same money through halal. He will have the same and Allah will be pleased with him. وكذلك الزاني لو ترك الركوب ذلك الفرج حراما لله لأثابه الله بركوبه أو ركوب ما هو خير منه حلالا. If a man indulging in zina abstains and restrains, Allah will give him that same woman or something better. Allah will give him the same woman or something better through lawful and legitimate means. The hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu narrates it. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Nadrul rajul fi mahasin al mar'a sahmun min siham iblis. To glance at the beauty of a woman is an arrow from the poisonous arrows of the devil. من أعرض عن ذلك السهم, he who restrains and abstains from this poisonous arrow of the devil, أعقبه الله. Look at the words of the hadith. If you study this word, if you do some etymology of this word, if you dissect it and you analyze it, what's the root words? أعقبه يعقبه يعقب. أعقبه الله عبادة تسره. Allah will follow, Allah will replace, Allah will return. With what? عبادة تسره. He will be amongst those fortunate individuals who will enjoy an ecstasy while obeying Allah. A spiritual ecstasy. My brother, the thrill is not to talk to an illicit woman. By Allah, a man in sin, he is excited for the moment and for the 23 hours he's a restless individual. He will sleep when others are awake, he will be awake when others are sleeping. He will be sitting in his house with his wife and children, the best of amenities and luxuries, the best of homes and abodes, but he will be devoid of happiness. This will be the consequences of sin. May Allah let my eyes open today, may Allah let your eyes open. This is the harsh reality. One youngster says, I read in one kitab, he says, I was walking by night, my gaze fell on a strange woman, suddenly I seen myself drawn towards her, I tried to lure her and invite her, and it was a bright night, the stars were shining upon us, and I said to her, ما يرانا إلا الكواكب ما يرانا إلا الكواكب. It's a bright night, it's only the stars that are shining upon us, come close to me, we could perhaps indulge and enjoy, and we could satisfy our fantasies. What an answer came from that girl. She said, فَأَيْنَ مُكَوْكِبُهَا فَأَيْنَ مُكَوْكِبُهَا. You say that only the stars, we are only exposed to the stars. What about the creator of the stars? Are we not exposed to him as well? فَلَمَّا جَنَّ عَلَيْهِ اللَّيْلُ رَأَى كَوْكَبًا قَالَ هَذَا رَبِّي فَلَمَّا أَفَلَ قَالَ لَا أُحِبُّ الْآفِلِينَ. The stars will disappear, appear and disappear. But the creator of the stars, you cannot veil him, he never disappears. صاحب الشهوة عبد إذا غلب الشهوة أضحى ملكا. Here we have a conflict of definition. And let me say something at this juncture. We join the world in the slogan of empowering and liberating women, but we differ grossly in the definition of empowering. We join the slogans of liberating women. We are in harmony with those sentiments, but we differ grossly. Our definition of liberating a woman is not enslaving her for material gain. We beg to differ. Our definition of a slave, the poet encapsulates it, captures it in these couplets. He said, the one who lives a life governed by his whims and his ego has shackled himself by his own doings. The day he musters the courage to overpower his ego, proportionately he will unshackle himself with his own doings. So has not our cell phones literally become a cell of a jail? Has it not become a literal? That's why one person said, what's the definition of a cell phone? I said, tell me. He said, instant torment. We're having a good social discussion, and the man disappears, and his mood changes, and he's gone, and this could happen with roaming, it happens abroad also. Why these gadgets are governing my life? And I'm made to believe that, you know what, I want time, I'm moving it up. Ibn Jawzi rahmatullahi alayhi goes on to say, and I hope, I cry to Allah, and I always beg Allah before I start my talk, that, oh my Allah, let me say those words that touch my heart, that make me come close to you, my Creator. Make my friends and the general ummah come close to you, my Allah. Let it open our eyes. We are living in trying times, my brother. We are living in trying times. Amir ibn Abdullah al-Tamimi radiallahu anhu, a tabi'i, what he used to say, Allahumma, innaka khalaqtani bi'amrik, wa aqamtani fi balaya hadhihi al-dunya bi-mashi'atik. ثم قلت لي استمسك ولكن كيف استمسك إن لم تمسكني بلطفك يا قوي يا متين. Oh my Allah, you created me because you decided to do so. Then you subjected me to the trials of this world and you put me in an era that you had decreed in which I had no choice. Then you impressed upon me to exercise restraint and caution. I only ask you politely, how can I achieve this if you don't hold my hands? I only politely ask you, my Allah, in this ungodly environment, where I barely exit from here and there's a billboard to invite me, and there's an SMS to tempt me, and there's the seductive nature to seduce me, and there's no fabric to the community and no fiber to the society, and the junior have no regard for the seniors, and it's a world driven by lust coupled by monetary gain, and there's butchers and massacres, and what is happening, my Allah? Sometimes when I read the quotations of the pious predecessors, I have a feeling that their words were not so opportune at the time that they said it as they are today. I said, Ya Allah, this man said it when he said it, but these words of his are more relevant today than that day. Imam Shafi said, لم يبق في الناس إلا المكر والملك شوك إذا لمسوا زهر إذا رمقوا. In his prayer he said, Oh my Allah, there's nothing left in this world but deception and delusion, Oh my Allah. There's only hypocrisy and smoke screening, my Allah. When I look from a distance, these humans look like blossoming flowers. But my Allah, when I get close, I see every one of them are thorns and they're ready to prick me. And I think of these words of Imam Shafi. I said, I don't know if they were so relevant in his era as they were today. Are not the people looking like blossoming flowers? But get into business. Get into business with someone. And I'm afraid, my friend, you will run further than you ever ran from any beast. Huzaifa ibn Yaman said, I foresee an era coming. Only he will be rescued from the tide of that ocean, from the dark tunnel. The one who begs Allah like how a drowning person begs Allah. يأتي عليكم زمان لا ينجو أحد إلا من يدعو كدعاء الغريق. When the internet and modern technology made its first appearance, it was embraced with excitement, coupled with bliss. It has become a global village. We can communicate. Gone are the days of physical address and telegram. We've moved on. We're on Twitter. We're on SMS. We're on email. We're on Skype. We're on this and that. And we're seeing how the world became smaller and communication became easy. And I heard of an article and I read about it. A professor in one country and a surgeon in another country. And an entire orthopedic procedure was done through SMS communication. Wow, brilliant, meritorious. He who uses technology to his advance, great, we have no issues. But I'm afraid we've come at the crossroads, as the Quran says. The Quran does not refute the benefit of gambling, lotteries. People have, charitable organizations have been held. Look at the profoundness of the Quran. مَنَافِعُ لِلنَّاسِ وَإِثْمُهُمَا أَكْبَرُ مِنْ نَفْعِهِمَا وَإِثْمُهُمَا أَكْبَرُ مِنْ نَفْعِهِمَا. Yes, indeed. Alcohol in moderation has its benefits. Gambling generates some income, but without doubt its evils far more surpass its goods. I wonder, but the world has become so driven by monetary that we would admit and confess that technology is now being at a minus, at the detriment of our community. It is one of the key reasons of breaking marriages, and you can read from mainstream media. You don't have to read from alternative media. But everything is driven by money, and wherever we see revenue coming, it will have to continue. So what did Huzaifa ibn Yaman say? A time will come, none will be rescued. None will be rescued but the one who begs Allah like a drowning man begs Allah. A drowning man? Allah help me, I'm drowning. Rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. Is that how he cries to Allah? No, he cries from the recesses of his heart. He's holding on to a straw. أَلَّا يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَى. That is what Allah says. I respond to the call of the desperate because it's sincere. My brother, how are you calling your Allah for the salvation of your youth? How are you asking your Allah? Is it a regular 5-minute prayer? You've got to beg and beseech and implore your Allah. His sovereignty remains intact. He is not threatened by anyone. He is not intimidated by anyone. He is not obligated by anyone. He is not overpowered by anyone. He is not answerable to anyone. So Ibn Jawzi rahmatullah alayhi writes, reflect over this. It's so deep. It's so deep. He says, إِنَّ مُخَالَفَةَ الْهَوَى تُقِيمُ الْعَبْدَ فِي مَقَامٍ مَنْ لَوْ أَقْسَمَ عَلَى اللَّهِ لَأَبَرَّ. If you, in harmony with our topic, if you have the courage and you can muster the power to tame this wild ego, to govern this lustful ego, then it would elevate you to